Hello friends, Rhonda Garvin Conaway here with some recommendations for you. This week, many folks are celebrating Thanksgiving, and it is traditionally known for giving thanks. This November at Act Two Share Our Stage, we are exploring what it means to be happy and strategies to create a more satisfying life. For me, it's a perfect time to talk about how gratitude and these practices are proven strategies to achieving happiness and satisfaction. Consider this quote: "It is not happy people who are thankful. It is thankful people who are happy." For me, this means our attitude fuels our actions, which directly affects our sense of satisfaction in life. So let's get to it. Here are my three recommendations to incorporate gratitude in Thanksgiving rituals, not just at Thanksgiving time, but into your life. Then they become actions that create positive outcomes. Here's recommendation number one. Prepare for a thankful mindset and attitude. When you wake up in the morning, do a quick scan of what's going on for you, those you love and care about, the world. Acknowledge all that you notice with a truthful lens. Now ask yourself, what do you appreciate about your current reality? Put your attention on these ideas and focus on your appreciation. Remove expectations of what you think your life and circumstances should be. That's step one. You can return to this mindset practice at any point during your day. Recommendation number two. Actively practice thankfulness in how you express yourself. Let's take your attitude of gratitude and use it to walk through the world with a little more grace. The best way to practice living with genuine thankfulness is to counter toxic events. How do you do this? Think about others. Get outside of your own needs and wants. When you recognize what others are experiencing, then you can respond by being polite, considerate, use manners. Meet rudeness and impatience, go a little deeper with understanding and try to lose the judgment. Let others go in traffic, send good thoughts maybe to those who cut you off. Give well wishes to folks who seem irritable. Offer empathy when you encounter disgruntled behavior. Praise others around you, offer gratitude, compliments, celebrate milestones, give awards for their contributions, kind words, text, phone calls, notes, all those things. Third recommendation, at the end of the day, give thanks. When you're there, about to go to sleep, think about what you're thankful for. This has a really powerful effect on your brain and well-being. Use these final moments before you nod off to say, thank you. Sort through that which gave you immediate joy in those challenging experiences. Being grateful does not mean ignoring difficulty and pain. However, it does allow us to see the opportunity amid difficult times and use our personal power to reframe hardship. To recap, start each day with a grateful mindset. Take action and express your thankfulness to others, which you can actually also do to yourself. Express it to yourself, write yourself those notes, the calls, the texts, do it. And number three, at the end of the day, say thank you for even those things that are tough. And I promise that if you incorporate these three rituals, your overall sense of satisfaction and happiness will improve. So thank you for joining me today. I truly do appreciate it, and feel free to share this with anyone you think might benefit from it. Be thankful, feel satisfied, and be well.